Hi guys, welcome back to my vlog. So as you know, the NCA series is now over and now I'm going to start with the legal market series. So ये जो series है मैंने अपने seniors से जो यहाँ पे हैं उनसे थोड़ी सी consultation से जिनके काफ़ी international experiences हैं उनके consultation से और उनकी you know input से I have gathered some of those points and made a vlog out of all of this. So for today's vlog I'm going to discuss some of the myths that people have about the legal field in Canada and I'm also going to discuss like facts about it and everything in my attempt of this legal series is that you guys understand that there is a real picture to it. Nothing is so rosy about it and you should have that kind of clarity to yourself. You should have that kind of numbers and data जिससे आप यू नो यू कैन जज फॉर योर ओन सेल्फ दैट वॉट इज़ बेटर फॉर यू इवन इफ यू वॉन्ट टू इमिग्रेट एंड इफ यू वॉन्ट टू इमिग्रेट एंड इफ यू आर हियर देन वॉट काइंड ऑफ लॉ डू यू वॉन्ट टू प्रैक्टिस एंड वॉट आर योर स्ट्रेंथ्स एंड वीकनेसेस. सो ये सारी चीज़ आप अपने लिए इंडिविजुअल बंदा इवेल्यूएट करता है अपने लिए बट आपको कुछ फैक्ट्स पता होने ज़रूरी हैं और वो आपको एक्सपीरियंस से पता लगते हैं. मुझसे जो गलतियाँ हुई हैं आई एम ट्राई टू शेयर दैम सो दैट यू नो यू डोंट रिपीट दैम एंड यू हैव योर ओन काइंड ऑफ जर्नी इवन दो But still, I'll try and help as much as I can. And sometimes I will even in these future vlogs, I might just interview them and interview those kind of people who are foreign trained lawyers who found job here and who have had their own struggles. So you will know that what kind of hassle one faces and what are the benefits and what are the pros and cons basically. So let's discuss the myths today. And if you like my video, if you like this whole initiative of reaching out to people, then I would love it if you like, subscribe and share my video. Let's reach out to as many people as we can and let's help each other grow in this field. So yeah, so let's go and check out some of the myths right now. Achha, so one more thing I would like to add is ki maine ye jo sare myths aur stories banayi hain, it's because of you people. Logon ne mujhse question queries puche hain, though I could not answer all of them, but you know aapko broadly apne har question ka jawab mere vlogs mein mil jayega if you try and find. Okay, so let's discuss number one myth. The number one myth is, and this is the most common myth that I've faced till now and I'm getting these kind of questions and queries, is that if you become a lawyer sitting outside, give the NCAs and stuff, you can immigrate to Canada. This is not true. Your immigration status is different from your professional status. How to become a lawyer, NCA, FLSC, provincial things and everything like that is a subject of your professional choice. That is how you can transfer your equivalency from a Indian, Pakistani, Asian lawyer to basically a foreign trained lawyer to basically a Canadian lawyer. ये वो रूट होता है. इसका इमिग्रेशन से कोई लेना देना नहीं होता है. पहले आप ये देखो, फॉर इमिग्रेशनल दिस पर्पसेस यू शुड कंसल्ट अ प्रोफेशनल, बी इट अ लॉयर, बी इट अ एजेंट और एनीबडी, अ कंसल्टेंट. And then you see, it depends, it varies on your circumstances, on your points, on your other stuff. Because आपके लिए best route immigrate करने का कौन सा है? Student visa, work visa, have a status, and then probably think of becoming a lawyer. Or maybe you want to run both of these things simultaneously, so you can do that. But you have to keep in mind that these are separate issues. Achha, the second most interesting myth is that some people think that life of Harvey Specter is what like life looks like in Canada, a lawyer's life. It's not true, guys. I am so sorry to give you a reality check, but Harvey Specter ki jaise suits mein dikhate hain, wo probably yahan ke GD ke bachche honge jinhone yahan se law kari hai, yahan ka experience hai, yahan pe articling kari hai, unhone bhi you know 7 to 8 years easily diye hote hain apne career ko to start karne ke liye, jaise humne apni home countries mein liye hote hain. And for the same reasons they are given preferences, so there's nothing to feel bad about it. As a foreign trained lawyer you will find your route, but you will have your own kind of struggle. It's not going to be very easy or very smooth and it's not going to be hassle free. Apne kind of bends and ups and downs and lows sabko jhelne hote hain, so you will have kind of that kind of life. But do not come with the picture that you will have a Netflix series going on in your mind and that's how life is going to be. थ्री क्वेरीज दैट जो LLM कर लेते हैं या पैरालीगल का कोर्स कर लेते हैं या लॉ क्लर्क का कोर्स कर लेते हैं उनको NCAs नहीं देने होते हैं. दिस इज अ मिथ, दिस इज अ बिग टाइम मिथ. अनटिल एंड अनलेस आपका LLM का कोर्स जो है उसमें आपको NCA सब्जेक्ट्स की सर्टिफिकेशन नहीं हो रही है, टिल द टाइम दे आर नॉट सेइंग दैट यस यू विल बी सर्टिफाइड टू यू नो क्लियर दीज एग्जाम्स विद इन द LLM कोर्स, टिल दैट टाइम यू माइट हैव टू यू विल हैव टू नॉट माइट यू विल हैव टू गिव द NCA एग्जाम्स. NCA एग्जाम्स आर फेडरल एंड यू नो आई हैव डिस्कस्ड इन माई प्रीवियस व्लॉग्स अबाउट देम, यू कैन गो चेक देम आउट. But always keep this in mind that LLM is probably better for a person who wants to go into, you know, research and professional. And as a practicing lawyer, agar aapko practice karni hai as a lawyer in Canada, you have to give the NCA exams. Unless, I again said, unless your LLM course covers those subjects. Okay, this one might hit your heart and I feel you. Because मुझे भी लगता था that lawyers can get paid somehow, something will happen and कुछ ऐसा होगा. But however, I have seen and I have done myself volunteer with law firm and to, you know, climb your ladder up the stairs. It is not like कि आप अभी lawyer बने हो तो आपको अभी पैसे मिलने लग जाएंगे. नहीं हाँ, आप NCA कैंडिडेट हो और आपको अपना लॉयर के लिए जगह बनानी है, यू हैव टू यू नो गेट इन टू द सिस्टम, यू हैव टू इंटीग्रेट विद द सिस्टम एंड फॉर दैट यू हैव टू बी वेरी ओपन माइंडेड. यू हैव टू टेक आउट दोज काइंड ऑफ जो आपके दिमाग में ब्लॉक्स हैं कि नहीं हम तो इतना करके आए हैं, हमें तो ये वो, हमको तो एक्सपीरियंस भी है ये वो. आई अंडरस्टैंड आपका एक्सपीरियंस मैटर भी करता है, बट टू गेट इन टू द कैनेडियन सिस्टम इवन इफ यू हैव टू वॉलंटियर फॉर से 2-3 months, इट्स लाइक एन एसेट ऑन योर CV. Nobody विल सी दैट यू आर पेड और नॉट पेड, बट वैन यू गो फॉर जॉब इंटरव्यू पीपल विल सी दैट येस दिस पर्सन हैज कम सम काइंड ऑफ लोकल एक्सपीरियंस एंड लोकल एक्सपीरियंस रियली रियली मैटर्स. सो इट इज़ ऑल्सो गुड कि आप वॉलंटियर करो या आप जाके यू नो इवन इफ यू बिकम अ लॉ क्लर्क एज एन NCA कैंडिडेट आप लॉ क्लर्क कर लो, पैरालीगल बन जाओ और स्टार्ट. यू विल प्रॉब्ली हैव टू समवेयर समटाइम स्टार्ट फ्रॉम द स्क्रैच एंड व्हाई नॉट डू इट एंड गेन दैट काइंड ऑफ हैंड्स ऑन एक्सपीरियंस. Okay guys, so fifth myth is that lawyers throughout Canada are paid uniformly. Guys, that is not true. Although US you fall under a certain bracket, but aapka experience, demography of the place, your geography of the place where you're located or where you're going to practice, what kind of hours that you put in, what kind of areas that you practice in, multiple factors decide your kind of salary. However, a mean salary for 2 years, 3 years, 4 years experiences I'm going to share in my future vlogs. And but what you need to keep in mind is that there is no one uniform criteria to get you one kind of package. Agar aap top Toronto, वैंकूवर मेन सिटीज देख रहे हो, जो मेन सिटीज हैं उनमें आप जॉब करना चाहते हो, जैसे यहाँ पे सारे लोग डाउनटाउन टोरंटो में जॉब करना चाहते हैं, सो देन यू हैव टू नो योर कंपटीशन इज गोइंग टू बी वेरी टफ. सैलरीज दो आर वेरी हाई, बट द कंपटीशन इज सो टफ फॉर फॉरेन ट्रेन लॉयर्स देयर जस्ट बिकॉज दैट यू कैन you have to compete with the people who are born bred and who have done their JD from here. So what I suggest is that people should, you know, go out and explore further areas, because ऐसे कितने rural areas हैं जहाँ पे job market आपकी आपको jobs मिल सकती हैं, because वहाँ पे lawyers की कमी है, वहाँ पे लोगों की कमी है, and you can, you know, try and think of all those offbeat places. So then that can help you to find a job maybe easily and maybe of your area of interest. This one's very interesting. The myth says that XYZ person is your friend, relative or senior from law college and can employ you straight away from the moment you land in Canada. So, you know, by this I do not mean to discourage or say that your relatives or your family or friends are not helpful. No, people do guide you, people do give you sometimes recommendation also based on your relationship with them, and people can help you find jobs also. The networking is always the key to find jobs in Canada. But I just state that do not keep high expectations. I have seen so many people that keep high expectations from their relatives and from seniors from colleges. But aisa nahi hota hai. You need to understand that everybody has had their own kind of struggle, and which is true also, which is fair enough. Give them that scope that they can, you know, just guide you. Kisi pe itna bhi expectation depend na ho jo, aur kisi se itna bhi wo, you know, do not just try and put it on the other person. Take responsibility for your action. You are an adult who is immigrated to Canada with a law degree or without a law degree, but you have come here and you can probably set your own path. So just network with people, but without the intention of gaining something out of it. Just network in general, just expect in general, but do not keep very high expectations. Actually, usually I have seen that people experience this mistake, and this myth that all lawyers know all type of laws. No guys, that's not true. Yahan pe bhi same cheez hai that there are experience, expertise in something. So for example, agar aapka back home IP ka, IP intellectual property ka experience achha hai, so you would want to find your area of expertise and you would like to, you know, work in that. So find your area of expertise, because it is always good to be in some kind of area rather than be a jack of all. One of the good things about this myth is that you can do multiple things, and yes, I'm not kidding you that people actually believe that lawyers are only lawyers. No, lawyers sometimes are businessmen also. After all, to run your own firm is also business, right? Then lawyers can wear multiple hats, like they can become CA, CS, and they can have extra source of earning. Canada mein usually people have extra source of earning. And you can also do that. You can become a business partner. Maybe you want to become a director in some company. Maybe you want to do anything like that. And you can do that. You are eligible to do that. However, you professional qualifications may vary, and you can check that out. But all I mean to say is that lawyers are just not lawyers. Lawyers can do multiple things. And so this option is very good for you while you're becoming a lawyer and you want to probably do something else on the side. Okay, some of my biggest, I would say this was my biggest fear, ki mujhe laga ki I do not have that kind of English accent to my tone, to my English. But you know, when I went to court, when I joined the law firm I'm working with, and when I just went to the court with them and saw a few arguments, I realized that substance is over form. You should have knowledge of your law, of the file you are working on. You should have knowledge of the facts. Timeline same way जैसे अब इंडिया में हर चीज़ मैटर करती है, सेम वे यहाँ पे भी करती है. द जुडिशरी आई सीन इज सो, यू नो, इंडियंस इतने ज़्यादा हैं, पाकिस्तानी इतने ज़्यादा हैं यहाँ पे, दैट दे आर वेरी मच कम्फर्टेबल विद द इमिग्रेंट्स एंड दे मेक यू फील वेरी कम्फर्टेबल. स्पेशली द जुडिशरी इज़ वेरी सपोर्टिव ऑफ द होल कॉन्सेप्ट. And the only thing is that you need to be a good lawyer, obviously, to present your case in court. That's all I've seen. Do not be conscious about your English, do not be conscious about your accent, nothing matters. It's substance over form, and the confidence is the key. So remember to be confident. Even if you are an internationally trained lawyer, you still have done hard work, you have cleared those NCAs, aapne bar exams diye hain, so aapne apni articling wali condition puri kari hai, ya aapne jo bhi kara hai, but confidence is the key. Okay, so the last myth is that all lawyers are courtroom lawyers and your international experience won't count. Guys, I want to say that this is so wrong. All lawyers are not courtroom lawyers. Lawyers do multiple work, like negotiator, government counsel, researchers. Legal researchers is a big trend. Then, you know, you can do so much with your law degree. There are so many. In fact, I'm going to share a report in my description box which say alternative careers for lawyers, and it's going to be really helpful. The second thing I want to tell you guys is that international experience does count. Especially if you have, you know, transferable kind of experience. Agar aapka corporate commercial experience hai, banking finance ka hai, to aap logon ke liye to it's not that kind of a hassle to integrate that work with this work, because international experience, as we all know, is very transferable. But agar aapka jaise ek litigation lawyer ka experience hai, ye hai wo hai, to you know that how important rules of civil procedure are, how important rules of criminal procedure are. Same nahi yahan pe bhi hai, it's absolutely same, but you just have to understand that your international experience does give you an edge. It is not like it won't give you an edge, and there are some employers out here who look out for that. Jaise contract, agar aapka contract forte hai, आपका पेटेंट फोटे है, सो देर आर सम काइंड ऑफ जॉब्स विच आर सो स्ट्रिक्टली फॉर दोज काइंड ऑफ पीपल. आई नो लॉयर्स जिन्होंने यहाँ पे एनसीए करा भी नहीं है, बार भी नहीं करा है, बट स्टिल दे हैड सच बिग गुड एक्सपीरियंस ऑफ कॉन्ट्रैक्ट्स एंड दे आर कॉन्ट्रैक्ट स्पेशलिस्ट हियर. हो सकता है आने वाले ब्लॉग्स में आई इवन इंटरव्यू वन ऑफ दोज पर्सन हु इज अ कॉन्ट्रैक्ट स्पेशलिस्ट हियर. एंड सेम वे पेटेंट एजेंट्स, So you just want to see that what works the best for you. Maybe you want to take up something else and do law on the side, give those exams, give the NCA, give the bar side by side, and want to take up some other job. So you can always do that. Guys, I hope this myth thing was useful for you guys. You know what? Because I wanted to get these myths out of the way so that now in the future vlogs, we can discuss everything without any hassle. And we're going to discuss legal market trends in the future vlogs. I hope you like this attempt. If you do like it, hit the like button, share and subscribe so that aapko clear picture milti rahe as much as I can give you. And stay home, stay inside, take care of yourself, study hard if you're studying, and work hard if you're working. So all the best, bye. Please know, nothing to discourage you guys. It's just the clear picture.